Science can be both fun and functional, but when you mix a little Halloween, you get some spooky science. STEM educator Steve Spangler shows us some Halloween science experiments that are easy to do in your kitchen.
I think parents and teachers out there are making science, making Halloween fun using science, because it's the perfect chance for us as teachers to sneak in some science, and it's a great opportunity to get kids excited about learning, and they don't even know it because it's Halloween.
Yes, that's exciting. So what do you have for us first?
First of all, it's important at Halloween time when you go to the grocery store, go to the customer service area and ask them, do you have dry ice? And many times they'll say yes, they know to stock up this time of year. So how about a little dry ice safety for you and some things that you can do with dry ice? If you haven't, of course, seen it before, I bet you have. Here it is right here. This is dry ice. It's actually frozen carbon dioxide. It's 110 degrees below zero, so you'll notice I have to touch it with a glove. Mm-hmm. And it's not really water at all. It's not ice. It's frozen carbon dioxide. So when you drop it in water, you're going to start to see it bubble and you're going to get some water vapor. So the simplest thing to do is you get 5 or 10 pounds of dry ice. It should cost you $1 or $1.50. And let me show you the first little experiment. Watch, you can use two glasses, but I love these cylinders because they're safe for kids. Kids can't get their hands down inside. But watch this, two pieces of dry ice, one in cold water, right? And the other one, take a look at this. Let's use hot water and this over here. This just goes to prove to you that you should always use warm water when you're playing with dry. Look at that.
Oh my goodness.
That's there. So all the kids want this, that's for sure. And notice that it's safe for them to be able to touch now. I can hang on to this. I can actually see that vapor coming off, and that's that spooky kind of look that you get with dry ice. Now, if you really want to make it fun and totally out of control, a couple drops, believe it or not, of soap will do the trick. Okay? A couple drops of soap in here now. Now, we'll take that carbon dioxide and contain it in the bubbles. So watch, just in your kitchen, find a pan like this and put it down below. And now watch what happens when you put a little bit of soap inside. All of that carbon dioxide gets caught in there. Here it comes. Tell me how fun this is.
Oh, look at this.
For the kids to touch. Look at this. They can touch and they can play, and you secretly get them to take a bath at the same time. So wash. All right, so now all of a sudden you've got bubbling potions that are here, but watch, you can get color-changing potions in the kitchen as well. So if I move this back here, take a look at what happens if we do the same thing, but now to the water, we've put something in this water, and look at this, it is red cabbage. We took red cabbage, and we took the leaves off, and we ground up the leaves and made a juice out of them, strained it, and this is what we have, is cabbage juice. So you're going, what are you using cabbage juice for? Cabbage juice is a natural indicator. It changes if it's an acid or a base. So if you put vinegar in here, it would change color. If you put ammonia in here, a cleaning solution, it would change color. Well, carbon dioxide is an acid. So watch what happens. If I drop this down here, watch what happens. Take a look at the color change that you get. So it happens pretty quickly. We go from this purple that you see here. It's bubbling up something called carbonic acid. So you start to see it change color just a little bit, and it'll start to turn blue, and then when it goes from blue, it turns, you're starting to see that color change. Here it is right here. Look at that blue that's here, and all of a sudden, like magic, it's going to go to yellow, to green, and to yellow,
cool.
So it's this color-changing potion that's there just because you're bubbling carbon dioxide. Isn't that fantastic?
Yes.
It all happened just a little bit differently because the chunk of dry ice was just a little bit different on those as well. So if you want a drink that's great for Halloween as well, let's say you're doing a little Halloween party, watch what you can do. Nobody wants to drink cabbage juice, but what you could do is this. You take apple juice, for example, and you could put it in a cauldron. Now, sometimes at a restaurant, they'll drop a little dry ice in. I don't recommend it because we're going to have kids, but I'll take a cauldron or a big bowl, and I'll pour the apple juice in there, and then you take dry ice and you drop it in the apple juice. It does two things. It makes it really cold, number one, but number two, when it's all gone, all the ice is gone, the dry ice is gone, you now, when you drink the apple juice, it's tingly on your tongue, and that tingly sensation on your tongue is the carbonic acid. So that's how they use that to be able to carbonate a beverage. Look at all the cool things that you can kind of do with dry ice.
That is so cool.
It was very fun. So lots of fun things to do with the kids.
That.
Yeah, it's going to be raining most of the day tomorrow, so
yeah.
You might as well get some dry ice and have some fun.
I love it.